Set up here, I've got two of Hard Korr's 200 watt solar mats or solar panels. The performance is about the same, but there's a big difference in price and some differences in quality. I'm going to run through that with you now. Hey folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with a question that's interested me for a little bit, and I'm sure it will you too, so I'm gonna try and answer it. And that's, what is the difference between these two Hard Korr solar panel products here? This is their 200 watt portable solar panels, kind of a flexible panel with their Crocskin armor. And this is one of their newer offerings, which is a 200 watt solar blanket. Now, this one comes at a really appealing price. So I guess the question is, do you need to upgrade to the higher end one? And what are the benefits of both? And I'm here today to try and answer that for you. So we'll point out some of the differences. Firstly, obviously a difference in size and weight. This guy's about 9 kilos. This guy's about 7 kilos. Now this weighs a bit more because there's a little bit more to the solar panel, which we'll go on to shortly. And also the pack size is different with the larger one here, which is the more expensive one, is about 71 centimeters long, 53 in height, and probably about 5 to 6 centimeters in depth, depending on where you measure it. If you add the wires and things at the front, it's a bit thicker. This guy's about 35 centimeters by 37 centimeters and probably about 5 or 6 centimeters in thickness, plus the wires at the front as well. But it's obviously a much more compact unit to pack. I've got one of these guys and I find it slides easier next to my fridge, but it is a much bigger unit to pack. Next thing, I'm gonna just pull everything out of the bag, show you what comes with the bag, and we'll look at some of the materials. Now, one first noticeable difference is that this, the Crocskin solar panel comes in its own bag here. So all of this fits within this bag, whereas the lifestyle panel over the other side here, the actual packaging is the actual material on the outside here. And just on the materials, this is a lightweight sort of poly cotton canvas on the outside here, but back over to the Crocskin panel here, this is a 1680D nylon. So it's a much tougher exterior fabric on this guy here. So get a bit more durability out of this one. Before we go into the details of the solar panels, look at what actually comes with the kit. Now, they both come with a cable. The lifestyle one comes with a 6 meter cable that's gonna go between your battery and your solar controller, whereas the Crocskin solar panel, it's only a 5 meter cable, so you get 1 meter less of cable with this guy here, but they're both gonna do the same thing. The battery clamps, the lifestyle one just comes with a short battery clamp and Anderson connector, whereas the Crocskin one comes with a 1.5 meter clamp, alligator clips with an Anderson connector on there as well. So the meter that you lose out of this cord, you gain with these guys here. And one of the big differences are with the solar controllers that come with the two. Now the lifestyle one comes with a 15 amp, just a digital PWM controller. This is gonna cover AGM, calcium, wet and gel batteries. It's got two little USB outlets there, which are kind of handy, but if you have a lithium battery, that guy's not gonna work. You're gonna need to get yourself another solar controller. Whereas the Crocskin solar panels come with this latest 15 amp digital controller that's Hard Korr have. Now this is a 5-stage controller that's also gonna cover lithium batteries. So it follows a really healthy charge pattern for your battery. So it's gonna charge your batteries more efficiently. You also got a lot more information on the front of the panel here, including battery charge state indicators, a digital display that we'll show you shortly. So an upgraded solar controller that you get with your Hard Korr Crocskin solar panel. Now with either of these, you can remove these and attach them directly to a DC to DC charger or something else. But for those who are new to solar, you need to have one of these in your system. You can't connect your solar panel directly to your battery. You need this in there because the solar panel puts out a lot of voltage. This kind of settles that down and keeps a nice steady charge going into your battery. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is lay the solar panels out, and we'll talk about the panels themselves and how it looks when it's rolled out. Okay, so I've got them laid out here. Now there's some obvious differences here. The lifestyle panel here on my right has got lots of different solar panels. It rolls up more like a blanket, so you can either lay it flat or hang it and put it over a bonnet. Whereas the Crocskin portable panel here, they're more like 4 larger panels. Now on top of this, in terms of mounting options, this also has a little kickstand on the back here. So when this is standing upright, it sits at a 35 degree angle so you can get maximum efficiency to the sun. You don't have that feature with this guy here. What you do have though is little hook points on the top of this mat here, just nylon hooks that you can use to hang that on the side of a car. Whereas this guy actually has brass or metal eyelets in the corners here, either for pegging it down or for tying something to hang it either vertically or horizontally on the side of a car or whatever as well. So you've got different mounting options. Jumping into the actual solar panels themselves. Now they're the same A-grade monocrystalline cell, so they both have the same performance. The output of both of these mats, they're both 200 watt mats. This puts out, they say, about 10.68 amps, this about 11.1 amps. So in the scheme of things, there's not a lot of difference in the two, but it's mainly down to the durability of the solar panels themselves. This has got a copper cell backing with lots of points of contact behind it. There's a lot more that's gone into how this solar panel is put together in here. And it has this Crocskin armor over the top, which you can feel is quite durable, makes it more impact resistant. They say it's even good in hail. So it's quite a durable solar panel that's on this system here. So you're paying for durability. Whereas these are just a solar panel. They're still tough. They're not fragile by any means. You need to treat them with care, but I probably wouldn't leave this out, say in hail or anything. They're not as impact proof as this guy here. So far, the differences between the two really are, you get the same output. The performance is probably going to be the same. We're going to check that shortly, but you get more durability out of this mat here, plus that better solar controller. What I want to do next is set both of these up. I've got the same battery over there. I'm going to put them both in the sun. They're side by side. It's a clear day today. There's no clouds going over. So I want to plug one in. We'll check the output from one. Then I'll immediately unplug it, plug the other one in, check the output from that, and see if they compare pretty much. So they should compare comparably side by side. Now I've got the solar mat set up in just a little patch of sun here. Better be quick before the shade comes across. I've got the cable coming from the solar panel to what I'm going to use, the same solar controller here for both, so that we get the same readings or same comparable readings. I'm going to start by plugging the Crocskin Armour one in first, and we'll just plug that in, let it have a thing. So 12.3 volts and 0 amp hours, 2.3 volts coming in at 7 amps. Now it's mid to late afternoon here on about a 20 degree day, so that's 7 amps laying flat on the ground. If we were to angle that up, we'd get an even better feedback from that, or even better output from that. Now, I'm going to quickly unplug it and plug the other solar panel in here now, so that we can get a reading on that one as well. So we'll just give that a second. Amp hours, volts, that's now up to 6.8 amps. So just under that 7 amps, there's probably 30 seconds difference between the first and the second. So output's pretty much the same for both of them. What I just want to do quickly now is I've plugged the Crocskin one in again, and I just want to stand this up. I want to use the kickstand so it's sitting a little more up towards the sun, and we'll see how much difference that makes to the output. So these are the benefits of having this little kickstand in behind here. Now they say this 35 degree angle is optimal for the sun. So we should see, I don't think there's any shade on that at the moment. So that has now jumped up to 9 amps, and the sun is about to disappear behind a tree to my left here. Now it is getting to late afternoon here today. It's about a 20 degree day, and the shade is actually fast creeping over this mat here. Now I can see that's dropping down to about 4 amps. There are bypass diodes in both of these mats here. So if there's shade at one end, you still get output from the other. If there's shade across part of it, you still get part of the panel working. And that features in both mats. So now look, in terms of buying which one, look, if your budget's stretched, then you get really good output from the lifestyle mat that I've got down behind me here. You're just going to have to treat it with a little bit of care, but the benefit is it does pack up smaller, so it's easier to fit in a vehicle. But I remember the Hard Korr rep telling me once, he said, buy once, buy right. So if you can afford it and you've got the space, grab yourself this 200 watt mat. This is what I use, and I can set it up a little bit of time at the end of the day to get heaps of charge back in my battery after a day exploring. If solar is a little confusing to you, you're new to the world of solar, it's probably worth having a bit of a read. There is a fair bit to sort of ingest around it. You do have to have a battery in your system. You have to have the solar controller in the system, and there's a lot of variables. We've got a really good article. Check the comments below. We'll put a link to that article there so you can have a read to try and understand how you can calculate your solar requirements in your campsite. Now these are both great mats, both great quality. I'd say if your dollars can afford it, get this guy, but if not, you're getting a really good mat with a lifestyle panel here, and it's going to charge your battery just as quick. This guy, also with a better quality make, comes with a better warranty too, so that might be a consideration for you. But if you want more information, check him out online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all our latest information, or check out some other videos like this one down here.